बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। अस्सलामु अलैकुम, वेलकम टू माय चैनल प्रोफेसर हसन हमायूं। वी हैव स्टार्टेड बेसिक स्टैटिस्टिक्स कोर्स एंड टुडे इट इज़ लेक्चर नंबर 13 ऑफ दैट कोर्स। फ्रॉम द लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव स्टार्टेड द टॉपिक ऑफ प्रोबेबिलिटी डिस्ट्रीब्यूशंस। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, बिफोर स्टार्टिंग टुडेज इम्पॉर्टेंट लेक्चर, I request everyone subscribe to my channel, like and share my channel and click the bell icon for the notifications of the next videos. Let's start. Question number 1 is, in binomial distribution the variance sigma square and mean mu are related by a part sigma square is equal to q multiplied by mu, b part sigma square is equal to mu over q, c part q square multiplied by sigma square is equal to mu, d none of these. Dear students, we know in binomial distribution mean is always equal to n multiplied by p and variance is always equal to n p q. Variance is sigma square is equal to n p. We can put mu for n p multiply by q, a very important multiple choice, a technical question. It means sigma square is equal to q multiply by mean of the binomial distribution. It means a part will be the correct option in the exam. Sigma square is equal to mu multiply by q. Now question number 2, in a binomial distribution if mean is k times the variance, what is the inverse of k? A part p, b part 1 minus p, c part 1 over p, d 1 over 1 minus p. The information which is given, that is mean is equal to k times variance, and we know sigma square k is multiplying over here. If it will be divided on the left side, mu over k is equal to sigma square. And what did we learn in the last question? Sigma square is equal to q times mu. Just compare these two equations. Sigma square is equal to sigma square, mu equal to mu. It means q will be equal to 1 over k. Q is equal to 1 over k. It means k will be equal to 1 over q. And they are asking the inverse of k. Inverse of k means 1 over k. If we take the reciprocal of these, it will be equal to q. K inverse is equal to q. K inverse is equal to, we can also say q is equal to 1 minus p. It means b will be the correct option in the exam. A very important question. The inverse of k is 1 minus p. Question number 3. Which one of the following may be the parameters of the binomial distribution? A part, when NP is equal to 2 and NPQ is equal to 4. If we divide these two equations, NPQ over NP, NPQ over NP is equal to 4 over 2. NP will be cancelled with NP, Q is equal to 2. That is not possible. The probability of failure will not be more than 1. It will not be equal to 2. Part B, N is 4 and P is 3 over 2 means 1.5. It is not possible. C part, N is equal to 8, P is equal to 1, Q is equal to 0. It is also not possible. Fourth, D part is NP is 10, NPQ is equal to 6. If we divide them, NPQ over NP is equal to 6 over 10. Q will be equal to 0.6. P equal to 0.4, and that will be the correct option in the exam. Please keep in mind. Question number 4. The moment generating function of the binomial distribution is given by MGF. Moment generating function of the binomial distribution is always equal to q plus p multiplied by e raised to power t whole power n. That will be the correct option in the exam. Question number 5. The skewness of a binomial distribution will be 0 if p is less than 1 by 2, b part, P is equal to 1 by 2 C part, P less than Q D part, P greater than 1 by 2, P will be equal to 1 over 2, B will be the correct option in the exam. Question number 6, the skewness of a binomial distribution will be 0 if P less than 1 over 2, B part P is equal to 3 over 4, C P greater than 1 over 2, D P is equal to Q. When there is no skewness in the binomial distribution, then P is equal to Q is equal to 1 over 2. A very important multiple choice question. Question number 7. In a binomial distribution, mean minus variance is equal to 2. Question number 8. Mean minus variance is equal to 2. And the next information is mean square minus variance square is equal to 12. What is the value of P? Our target is to find the value of P. We know A square minus B square is always equal to A plus B into A minus B. A square minus B square is mean plus variance into mean minus variance, and the value is given, that is equal to 12, and mean minus variance, that is equal to 2. Mean plus variance into 2 is equal to 12. 2 is multiplying over here. When it will be shifted on the right side, that will be divided by 12. It means mean plus variance is equal to 6. We have two equations now. Mean minus variance is equal to 2 and mean plus variance is equal to 6. And we have the concept of the mean and variance of the binomial distribution. Mean is always equal to NP. NP minus NPQ is equal to 2 and NP plus NPQ is equal to 6. If we add them, these will be cancelled and 2NP will be equal to 8. It means NP is equal to 4. And if we subtract them, these will be cancelled and you will have minus 2NPQ is equal to minus 4. NPQ is equal to 2. And if you divide these two equations, NPQ over NP is equal to 2 by 4. Q will be equal to 0.5 and P will also be equal to 0.5. P is equal to 0.5 will be the correct option in the exam. A very important multiple choice question for all the papers of statistics. Now question number 8. Which of the following distribution is not a member of power series family of distributions? A part Poisson distribution, B geometric distribution, C binomial distribution, D hypergeometric distribution. D will be the correct option in the exam. Hypergeometric distribution is not the member of power series family of distributions. Question number 9. Limiting form of hypergeometric distribution is A part Poisson distribution, B binomial distribution, C negative binomial distribution, D none of the above. Dear students, we know when n approaches to infinity in the hypergeometric distribution, it approaches to the binomial distribution. B will be the correct option in the exam. Question number 10. Probability mass function of the binomial distribution is probability x is equal to x is equal to ncx multiplied by p raised to power x multiplied by q raised to power n minus x. That is the formula of finding the probabilities in the binomial distribution. Question number 11. In binomial distribution, the range of x is a part 0 to infinity, b part minus 1 to n, c undefined, d 0 to n. We know in binomial distribution, the range is 0 to n. Question number 12. The binomial distribution has number of parameters equal to a part 1, b part 2, c part 3, d part 4. We know in binomial distribution there are two parameters. Parameters are 2 and they are n and p. It is question number 12. Now question number 13. in a binomial experiment with four trials. It means n is equal to 4. The variable x can take a part 2 values, b part 4 values, c part 5 values, d 6 values. Dear students, we know the number of values of x will be 0 to 4 actually. It means there are 5 values which the variable x can take. A very important question. Question number 14. The standard deviation of a binomial distribution, which is we know equal to under root npq, depends on a part probability of success, which is p, b part number of trials, which is n, c part probability of failure, it is q, d all of the above. Standard deviation depends upon n, p and q. D will be the correct option in the exam. Question number 15. For a binomial distribution with n is equal to 6, p is equal to 0.3, then probability of x is equal to minus 3 will be equal to a part 0, b part greater than 0, c less than 0, d none of the above. When we are to calculate the probability of a negative number, that will be equal to 0 in the binomial distribution, a will be the correct option in the exam. Question number 16. The binomial distribution is completely determined if it is known a part p only, b part q only, c part p and q, d, p and n. There are two parameters of the binomial distribution and these are n and p. It means d will be the correct option. If we know the value of n and p, then the distribution is completely determined. Question number 17, which is the last question of today's lecture, and that is, if p is equal to 0.6, if p is equal to 0.6 for a particular Bernoulli process, the calculations 9 factorial over 5 factorial multiplied by 4 factorial, 0.6 raised to power 5, 0.4 raised to power 4 gives exactly 5 successes in 9 trials. We know it is showing the small n number of trials and that is the number of successes. It shows 5 successes in 9 trials. That will be the correct option in the exam. Assalamu alaikum.